Hello, it's Kat, and in today's tutorial, I'm going to show you how I made these three animated GIFs inside Adobe Illustrator using a new plugin called GIF Studio.
You can find the GIF Studio extension by going to the Creative Cloud desktop app, clicking on Stock and Marketplace, and then clicking on Plugins, and you can go over here to the search box, just type in GIF, and that should bring it right up. Here we are, it is GIF Studio, so that's how you can find it. I will leave a direct link to this GIF Studio plugin in the description down below, as well as a link to the video from the creator of the plugin explaining some of the basics. So once you have the plugin installed, you can find it under your window menu and then extensions, and you should see it here. And when you open it up for the first time, it's just gonna give you these quick directions on what each of the functions do. You can see it's a fairly simple plugin, not too many buttons here to click. So we're gonna start with the animation process first, and I'll show you how I set up the file in order to create the final GIF. So my sample image for this demo is going to be this neon pumpkin, and we're going to animate it as if it's a physical neon sign that blinks. So the eyes and the face, I'm going to show the off states first, and then we're going to turn these back on. I like to keep my source art separate from the file that I'm using to make the GIF. So I'm going to create a new document here.
And my source art is 1080 by 1080 pixels. So I'm going to choose that same size to start this document and just make sure it's on RGB color.
So how GIF Studio works is really nice and simple. Basically, it takes each artboard in your document as a frame of the GIF animation, and then you can adjust timing and things from there. So that's why we need to start out with a multi-artboard document, and I'll show you how to set that up now.
You can do this in your initial file settings, but I want to show you how to use the artboard panel and tool to set this up if you already have a document you're working with.
I'm going to go ahead and zoom out pretty far here and open up my artboards panel. If you don't see this, you can get it under your Windows menu by going to Window, Artboards. And in the artboard panel, I'm just going to click this plus sign at the bottom to start adding artboards. I want to add 9 for this, so I'm going to click it 8 times. And you can see that kind of puts them in a weird configuration. So if you press Shift-O, you can grab your artboard tool. And then holding down Shift, you can drag it like you would your selection tool to grab all of those artboards. And there's this handy little reshuffle option, so you can rearrange your artboards. I want them to be 3x3, just to make it easy to see everything in one frame. So I'll click OK. And now we have this nice configuration of 9 artboards. And I'll switch back to my Layers panel. So it's important to keep your file organized when you're creating one of these animations. And the first thing I want to do is establish my background layer with all of the art that will be static and not animated. I'll switch back over here to my source art. And I'm going to start selecting everything that doesn't animate. So that'll be the background, the pumpkin shape, the face, and the stem. And with those selected, I'm just going to copy them using Control or Command C. And switching back to my animation file, I'm going to go to Edit, Paste on All Artboards. So now I have the static version of my image on all of the artboards. And I'm just going to name this background and lock that layer. And I'll add a new one above it, and we'll start transferring over the assets that will animate. The first frame of the animation will look just like this, so we won't actually need to add anything to that first artboard. On the second artboard, I want the first blink to turn on, like so. So I'm going to turn that layer on, select it, copy it, and clicking on my second artboard in, I will again use Control F to paste that in place. I know that I also want it to be on for this third frame, and I know that it will be on here, and it will be off for my fifth frame. I want two variations of the blink in my loop, so I'm also going to add it to my frame 6 and frame 7, where both sets of lights will be on for 2 frames. And then we will ramp back down, so the outer glow will be on here on frame 8, and it will be off for frame 9. Now I'll go back to my pumpkin art file and turn on blink 2, and we'll just grab that and copy, and heading back over to our animation file. The first time we will see the innermost glow turned on frame 3 here. It will be off again for frame 4 and 5, and then for frame 6 and 7, I want the full glow on for both of those, and then we will use the inner glow on frame 8 or 9. To ramp that back down. And because my first frame and my 9th frame are the same, we should get a perfect loop here. Let's go ahead and save my file quickly. And now we get to the fun part. So opening up my window menu and going to extensions, I'll open GIF Studio. And we're going to click this down arrow button. And this is just going to load every frame into GIF Studio. Depending on your art file and your computer specs, this may take a moment or two. And when it's done, you'll see every frame of your animation here. And by default, this is going to be fairly slow because these are all set to 1 second duration for each frame. So we're going to click the play button and just see what we have. So it's working, but it's definitely slower than I'd like it to be. So what we can do is click on our wrench icon here to get back to the settings. And if I click on the very first frame, to select it and then hold shift and click on the very last frame. So now we can change the duration of each frame all at once. And I think I want it to be about twice as fast. So I'm going to go with 0.5 seconds and we'll take a look. And that's pretty much the speed I was going for. So this works out really well. So now once you have your GIF set up and you've got the timing right, to export it, you click on this arrow here and you can save this just as you would anything else. And then if I open up my Explorer window and pop open the GIF, now you can see we've got a fully working animated GIF that you can use anywhere that you would normally be able to upload those files. This isn't something that you could usually do in Illustrator without the help of a plugin or extension. Normally you'd have to go into Photoshop for something like this, so it's really nice to finally have an option to be able to do this right out of Illustrator. Just to give you an idea of what a slightly more complex GIF would look like, I'll give you a look at the file setups for the other two GIFs that we previewed in the intro to this video. So first we have this floating ghost with his pumpkin buddy, and the ghost just kind of floats down and fades out, and then fades back in as he floats back up to create a perfect loop. So what I've done for this file setup is you'll see I have 30 artboards here, and I did this just to give myself a basis for doing the math. So I picked out how faded I wanted the ghost to be. In this case, he fades between 100% and 50% at the most transparent point. And I've just used some simple division to figure out what percent opacity the ghost should be on each of these artboards. So you'll see it just goes up by 3% for each frame. And it goes in the opposite direction if we're going back and he's fading back to 100%. Now I've also adjusted the Y value. For that, I basically did the same thing, reverse engineered how many pixels the ghost will move based on the highest value that I wanted it to be. So I knew that I wanted the ghost to shift about 45 pixels downward at its lowest point. So then I just took the Y value, which started at 540 here on my first frame, and did some quick math and figured out that I wanted him to move about 3 pixels down until his lowest point, and then again just reversing where he starts moving 3 pixels back up or his highest point. So it's the same theory, you just have to think things out through your artboards, and the plugin makes it very easy to quickly preview what your animation is looking like and then pop back into your file and make adjustments as necessary. Finally, I'll show you my setup here for the fall candle scene. This one was a bit more complex. Honestly, I was pushing the limits to see how far I could go. So for this one, I have quite a few more layers going on. There are actually 3 or 4 layers of glow on the candle that are fading in and out, much like we did with the ghost. So for those, it would just be, once again, adjusting opacity values. For the branches, I made these symbols, and I made the registration point right at the edge of the branch so that if I adjust the rotation value, that's how I'm getting those branches to sort of sway in the wind. So as you can see, you can do almost anything here that you would do with a regular GIF. The nice thing is, of course, that you can accomplish this all in Illustrator. I highly recommend using the paste to all artboards feature, as well as using symbols to keep your files a little bit more manageable. I am planning on going into more depth with this plugin and possibly setting up some actions or a script that could help speed up the workflow. So do stay tuned for that. If you have any questions, let me know in the comments. Happy illustrating and happy Halloween week. I hope you all have a great one, and I'll see you next time.